LifeVantage is at the forefront of nutrigenomics and biohacking. So we're going to take a look at where this company has come over the past 10 years or so. Way back in 2005, ABC News did an ABC investigative primetime special report about the formulator, Dr. Joe McCord, and this product that he brought to market. You're going to see John Quinones actually has his blood tested before he takes this product, and then 14 days after he's been taking this product. Look closely for how much his oxidative stress has been reduced. I also want you to pay close attention to what Dr. Joe McCord says about telling the difference in the blood between an 80-year-old and a 20-year-old after taking this for just 30 days. Let's take a look at this right now.
You want to get an edge on turning back the clock with just a few pills? Who doesn't? Well, it's no longer science fiction, but science possibility, a potential breakthrough. As I found out firsthand, there may be a way to erase years, at least inside my body. Granted, it's down the road, but some scientists are wondering if a new pill I took might offer a very long life.
It may not look like the Fountain of Youth, but inside this nondescript building, I'm about to become part of an exciting experiment, a kind of guinea pig.
Dr. McCord, okay.
I'm here at the University of Colorado in Denver to meet Dr. Joe McCord, a world-renowned scientist.
This is pretty exciting stuff you're finding, huh?
It is. We're very excited about it.
His latest research could very well unravel the mystery of aging itself. And his decades of experiments may have the potential of adding years to people's lives and possibly prevent chronic diseases like cancer, diabetes, and heart disease. It all centers around this small yellow pill, and for me, it begins with a blood test.
It wouldn't be the first time I've given blood for this company.
They want to check my levels of something called T-bars, which is a rough indicator of a person's actual age. T-bars can identify a condition known as oxidative stress, a kind of measure of the wear and tear on our bodies. Oxidative stress, like the rusting of an engine, is not a good thing.
Bad for the body.
Leading to disease.
Leading to disease and leading to malfunction, and importantly, leading to what we call aging. It is a slow progression of increasing oxidative stress. That's the main characteristic biochemically of the aging process.
The problem of aging begins with the very food we eat to give us energy. As our cells burn that food, they also release toxic chemicals. Those chemicals, you may know them as free radicals, react with all the components of our cells, literally bombarding them millions of times per second, damaging all our cells. The result? Oxidative stress. And we all have it. The body fights back with a system of defenses. It makes two antioxidant enzymes, catalase and SOD, whose job is to gobble up the free radicals before they can harm our cells. But as we get older, some of those toxic radicals overwhelm our enzymes and wreak their havoc. For a long time, scientists thought that antioxidant vitamins like C and E would lower it, but they don't.
As it's turned out in just the last 5 years or so, we see that they're not good enough tools. They're not powerful enough.
But this pill, he says, is powerful enough. In fact, many times more powerful.
So, doctor, how often do I take these?
And so, here I go. With that swallow, I've just become part of a potentially landmark scientific experiment. It's called Protandim, and tests on both mice and humans have already shown that it revs up the manufacture of those good enzymes in our bodies. More enzymes, fewer free radicals to harm us. Whether that will lead to longer life is still unknown. Experiments to see if mice live longer are about to get underway, but it's a tantalizing theory.
Right now, all we know is that this preparation decreases oxidative stress. Oxidative stress is not a disease, just like aging is not in itself a disease, but it's something that accompanies and is attached to many disease processes.
Have you discovered the Fountain of Youth?
I wouldn't put it that way, but we may have discovered something that will tell us a lot more about how we age what happens biochemically and maybe how we can slow it down. And so you can see the age-related impact.
Normally, oxidative stress, measured by those T-bars, increases with age. But in Dr. McCord's tests, taking just one pill of Protandim a day reversed that trend for everyone at every age, even for an 80-year-old.
They all are reduced to the level of oxidative stress that one would expect, frankly, in a newborn or a very young child.
Back to the oxidative stress levels of a child? It sounds too good to be true. Will Protandim work on me?
But what about my progress? After nearly 2 weeks now, it's time to get my results. Dr. McCord calculates the numbers. The result? My level of oxidative stress has declined dramatically.
45%, that's excellent.
Just look at where I fall on the graph, before and after.
Which, if extrapolated back, is the level you would see in a newborn baby.
Have we turned back the clock? Well, maybe not on the outside, but deep inside, within my cells. Yes, indeed.
Would you suggest I keep taking this supplement?
I would.
And so, ancient Eastern healing and modern Western medicine may soon be working together. High oxidative stress is associated with more than aging. It's been linked to hundreds of illnesses.
It's at the very center of many diseases. Liver disease, diabetes, emphysema, asthma. I've studied all of these. Strokes, heart attacks.
Even mental disease?
Yes.
Depression?
We do know that oxidative stress is part of those disease processes. I don't want to wait until I'm 80 years old and find out that I should have taken it.
The company that makes Protandim says its tests show the pill, made from ingredients used for centuries, is absolutely safe. But because it's being sold as a nutritional supplement and not a drug, Protandim does not need FDA approval for safety. For more, go to our website at abcnews.com.
So did you see how John Quinones' oxidative stress was reduced by 45%? Wasn't that incredible after just taking this for 14 days? And the Dr. John McCord said he could no longer tell the difference between the blood of an 80-year-old and that of a 20-year-old after taking this for 30 days? What happened since the airing of this primetime special report way back in 2005? Well, it was crazy. Over $5 million worth of orders came flooding in to Dr. Joe McCord's little biotech company. People were so excited about what Protandim could do in their bodies. Scientists and researchers watched that ABC report as well, and they were already studying oxidative stress. So they picked up the phone and they called Dr. McCord and they said, "Hey, Joe, we already understand oxidative stress, but we're intrigued with what you're doing. We would love to study your product." To which he said, "Well, I can't afford to fund research." And they said, "Don't worry, we have money. We're big institutions. This are places like LSU, Ohio State, VCU, Texas Tech, Harvard."
Right.
And the third amazing thing that happened was people invested in Dr. Joe McCord's little biotech company. They were so excited about what Protandim could do in the body. They were buying stock in his little publicly traded company, and literally the stock shot up from $1 a share to over $20 a share overnight, just based on sheer speculation of what this would do. Do you think the board of directors got a little excited when their stock shot up to $20 a share? Absolutely. And they said, "Hey, we've got to get up production. We've got to get this out in the marketplace." Because unfortunately, of that $5 million worth of orders that was initially placed, Dr. McCord was only able to fill about $200,000 worth. The guy's a scientist and a researcher. He wears a white coat. He's in a lab. He wasn't a marketer. He didn't have a bank of operators taking those orders in. So when they saw the stock shoot up, they got super excited about it. They said, "Hey, we've got to ramp up production. We've got to get supply mechanisms in place. We've got to get this out on store shelves." The problem was that took some time. There was a delay of several months before the product hit the shelves. And by the time the product was actually on the store shelves, places like GNC, Rite Aid, the Vitamin Shop, the excitement of that ABC primetime special report had been lost. People didn't know what Nrf2 was. People didn't know what Protandim could do. Protandim sat on store shelves from 2005 through 2008. Dr. Joe McCord's little biotech company was doing about $3 million a year in sales. That equated to about a half a bottle per store per month. That's it. And the problem was they were spending $5 million a year in production and marketing and advertising. Joe McCord's little biotech company lost $2 million a year for 4 years. $8 million in the hole. The stock, believe it or not, went from over $20 a share to 7 cents a share and was about to be pulled off the trading floor completely. The board of directors said, "We're done. We cannot survive this. We're hemorrhaging money. We've lost $8 million. We can't afford to lose any more. We need to sell this company." They brought in a consultant, and that consultant took one look at that ABC Primetime special report. He looked at the couple of patents we already had on this product and the couple of published research studies that were already there, and he said, "You guys are crazy. You don't need to sell your company. You need to change your marketing strategy." Mm-hmm. And they said, "Okay, how?" He said, "Well, you have an amazing story that needs to be told. People don't understand what your product can do. It needs to have people who are going to tell the story. It won't speak for itself.
Right.
You need to be in direct sales, person-to-person distribution. People are going to share this information over and over and over again." And Dr. McCord and the board of directors sat there for a moment, and they pondered, and they said, "So you mean like network marketing?" And he said, "Well, yes." And they said, "No, absolutely not. Our product is too good for network marketing." Well, it took a little bit of time, but that same consultant finally convinced them to do a 6-month trial where they got a select group of network marketers together and they kept it in store shelves simultaneously and they sold in both markets at the same time. And wouldn't you know it, in those 6 months, the network marketers outsold the retail stores by 300%. So in May of 2009, Lifeline Therapeutics closed its doors. LifeVantage was opened as a network marketing company, and we've grown from $3 million a year in sales to over $200 million a year. We're now open in 11 countries, about to open up in our 12th very shortly here, and the company is on the verge of absolutely exploding.